So you all talked a little bit about Don and getting involved in Don. How do you plan to, I guess, address the fact that if some of the general body members are not necessarily interested in Don or what they stand for? How do you, how will you kind of work with that?
I'll start. I believe that if people are interested in Don, then we can do things with it. But I don't think if there's no interest in the general body, I don't think it's necessary necessarily, or I don't think it's necessary for us to do Don activities. But if there's like interest, I'm totally capable of to like work with people.
I know that, especially for the Black community, Thon isn't an event where many of us feel comfortable going towards because it does tend to feel like a white space. But if there is enough interest towards Thon, we can start organizing events and fundraising for Thon. If not, then we could channel that energy into possibly a Black community type of fundraiser, not necessarily on Thon level of scale, but something small for the local area.
So Thon, you know, I guess it's not for everybody. If it's not, you know, what's, you know, some of the people stand for, then we can always, you know, find another option. We can find, like Mukuka said, we can find another way to channel that energy into something else.
So another aspect of this position is trying to find ways to raise money for the organization. So can you guys tell me a creative way you guys plan on raising money for that?
A creative way to there's a couple things we could do. We could do fun activities such as we could always sell food, you know, like cupcakes, things like that, like small things, desserts. We can plan, you know, like little fun events where we, like such as, you know, like a like flag football or something like that, along those lines, where we can, you know, put a dollar in or whatever for each person to play, and that way we can raise money for Torch to do stuff.
As far as fundraising, I think a lot of the things we've already been doing were pretty successful, such as, you know, the football booths, and there were some creative things like pie in the face. I know that had a lot of people coming out. But as far as other things, I think, like, depending on the season, there's some opportunities we can maybe take advantage of, like maybe like candy grams during like Valentine's Day, or maybe like, I don't know, something for like Bloom and White weekend, or, you know, just little stuff like that, like along the semester, that we can maybe take advantage of slightly better.
I agree with both of what they said. I personally participated in Pie in the Face. That was fun. I feel that we should expand on activities, fun activities like that. Like, seasonally, we could do, if we can find the money for organizing it as well as generating money from it, we can do like a dunk tank or other fun activities for the summer / early fall. We can also do things, again, like the candy grams for Valentine's Day. But I think focusing more on the fun part of it would be able to draw in more people, because it's like, hey, you want to pie somebody in the face? Let me go pie somebody in the face.
As incoming Torch Chair, prospective incoming Torch Chair, what's one main goal you would like to put most of your energy into, and, you know, at the end of your term, you'll be able to look back and say, I did that one thing at least?
Start anywhere.
I would say overall, it wouldn't be necessarily one specific event, but I would like to have a set number of people volunteer and come out. That also comes in part from being the PCI chair. Volunteering is a huge thing for me, and getting as many people coming out as possible is one goal that I have for both positions, possibly. So, for example, like having 20 people come out and volunteer, and then 30 people coming in and participating in the event, that would be my goal.
But like, what event would it be? What events do you have in mind?
We could do, again, doing pie in the face, possibly a dunk tank, other event. Even something as, that we did before, like football concessions, possibly even doing basketball concessions.
Yeah, kind of took my answer a little bit. Oh, was it hitting up? Oh, sorry.
What is one main goal that you hope to achieve as an incoming first chair?
Right, so one main goal that I plan to achieve as torch chair is to, you know, just get as much people in these community events that we can hold. And also another thing is to host a few more community events than we did for this academic year.
Yeah, so still I think getting a consistent number of people out to events would also be beneficial. Some events that haven't really been brought up, I think there might be potential in, is like different food events, you know, like Panda Express, I know they do some stuff, or maybe like Bubble Tea Downtown, you know, something people will come out to. And I think one way to do that is by, because people's schedules are so varied, so people might not be able to come to certain events, but like just being able to have them planned far enough ahead of time that people know when they're coming up and stuff like that could increase the number.
What community service have you done up here at Penn State, and how was it affected to you?
Excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I did the Martin Luther King Day of Service specifically, and also some stuff through the Millennium Scholar Program. Through those events, I've learned it's kind of, I don't know, I think it's pretty rewarding to do volunteer opportunities specifically. Something about, you know, giving back to the community around you, especially like when you're working with like younger people, which is, I know you've done a lot of, but being able to give back to just the community as a whole.
All the work that I've done with PCI, so the Envision event and the STEM fair that we had at the high school, I've also participated in the football concessions. I've also, outside of NSBE, done other concessions. I've done basketball concessions. I've done volunteer work through basketball. Could you repeat the question? How it's been effective is that it has allowed me to see the different ways that community service can be done through, whether it's through giving back directly to the community through helping out or through providing a service to them.
So while at NSBE, I've only participated in football concessions, but outside of NSBE, I've done football concessions, I always participate in volunteer groups back at home. So like during spring break, I helped autistic orphans. We like hosted a prom for them, so that was pretty fun. And every summer I volunteer at the hospital. I work in the ER. So that's just, you know, just a few of the things that I do as far as volunteer work goes.
Last question.
So another aspect of this position is that you have to be able to lead a group of people to do whatever, either fundraising or community service that you're trying to do. So could you tell us about leadership experiences that you've had and how What makes you a good leader to lead other people?
Okay, so well here here at Penn State, I haven't had much leadership opportunities, but I do have leadership experience as far as you know, in high school I used to I was captain of the track team. I helped to fundraise and host you know, charity events, and I was also the the school that I went to, it was a Catholic school, and I would help the pastor with running his weekly services.
So, again, I currently serve as the pre-college initiative chair, so I've had to organize events between both people involved in NSBE, so college students, working with school faculty, so both the teachers and the administration, as well as the high school students. So being able to do that has allowed me to see that being a leader is not always easy. You always have to make tough decisions. You always have to, you know, push somebody when you don't want to push that person. But being able to translate the goal that you have in mind and break it down into ways that the people that you're working with can understand has been the greatest impact that I've seen from being a leader, especially in NSBE.
Hey, well, currently I'm serving on the Millennium Scholar Program Council, which is kind of like just the people who communicate to the upper staff about like different issues that might arise. So I found that one important quality of being a leader is that you need to be able to talk to people and be able to like address their concerns and stuff and problems. So especially with as a torch chair, I believe it's important to get ideas from other people, and also, like I said earlier, just to be proactive with scheduling and making sure that people know when to come out.
All right, thank you guys.